So a few weeks back, I bought this MacBook Pro with the M4 Max chip. And while this is not my review, and I've definitely had an interesting time, we'll call it, stay tuned for that video, I would like to compare this pretty thin, low-profile machine to the AI server that I built a couple months ago on this channel. Actually, I built it about a year ago, but you guys saw the video for it a couple months ago. What I want to see is, how does this MacBook compare to that server? Yes, this MacBook is a little more expensive than I spent on that server. However, it is significantly smaller, we'll say, and it also uses significantly less power. So let's jump in. I want to talk about it. So right off the bat, I did a language model test in LM Studio using three different models. The models I used were Llama 3.3 Instruct, the 70 billion parameter model. That one was more of a just if I could see if it would work, not actually a real test. Neither of these machines run 70 billion parameter models well. The Hermes 3.1 8 billion parameter model, which is a little more ground to earth, and Microsoft's Phi 4 system, which is a 14 billion parameter model. So I'm just going to run through my list. So I'm just going to show you the results, and then I am going to actually show you guys a live race between this machine and the MacBook doing image generation. So on the AI server, which if you haven't seen that video, check it out up there in the corner. It's pretty much going to get torn down at this point, if that's not a spoiler. Let me tell you the prompt. So I have two prompts that I used for the LM Studio prompt. I did not check these for validity. I did not check the Python code, which we'll see in a second, for actual functioning. All I did was a raw numbers test to see, because I'm assuming that all three of these models probably can at least answer these questions at this point. So the first prompt was, tell me about all of the major conflicts in human history. In a brief summary, was on the AI server, it ran at 2.17 tokens per second. It generated 722 total tokens, and it was 1.68 seconds until the first token. So at idle, the big server pulls 150 watts. When you start running AI tasks like thinking models or image generation, that spikes up to about 250 watts, sometimes even closer to 380 watts. And I was measuring that with a pretty crude tool. So quite frankly, I'm going to round up and just say that that server is pulling 400 watts when it is running, which actually is still not that much in today's standards. If you built that same server using 40 series GPUs or something like that, or even 30 series GPUs, it would easily be pulling close to 2000 watts. Meanwhile, my MacBook Pro at its max can only pull 100 watts from the wall. And I say that because the charger that's plugged into the wall is only 100 watts. Now, I don't know what the battery is saying, and quite frankly, Apple does not make it easy to just get like a power reading. I'm betting under heavy load, I mean, we're still only talking maybe 60 watts here, but we can assume, given what other people have tested, it's significantly lower than 400 watts. So how did the MacBook do with the 70 billion parameter model? Well, it didn't run. No, I'm kidding. After a lot of finessing in LM Studio, I did actually get the 70 billion parameter to run on my MacBook Pro. So I have the M4 Max MacBook Pro with the 16-core chip and 48 gigs of RAM. How did the M4 Max chip do on a 70 billion parameter model? 3.04 tokens per second average. It generated 771 tokens, and it was 4.11 seconds to first token. Now I want to talk about those numbers. So first off, let's just talk about the tokens to second. So that's the most important number here. If you're not familiar with how modern LLM AI systems work, they basically are generative systems. So they generate tokens based on the previous token and the expected output. At 2.17 tokens, or even 3.04 tokens a second, that is a crawl. It was like watching dial-up, if you're old enough to remember that. Not usable in the slightest, but I wanted to run that big benchmark. You'll notice that my MacBook actually generated about 50 more tokens, 49 to be exact, than the AI server. I have no control over that. I gave the exact same prompts, no matter what, for the model and the computer. It just chose to do it, but to be fair, it was generating significantly faster. The time to first token is a really interesting one that I want to touch on a little bit later. So let's jump over to a more realistic model, because realistically, you're not trying to run a 70 billion parameter model at home. But let's talk about Hermes. So Hermes is an 8 billion parameter model, which is a really solid size. That is a really good size to be able to do like a coding assistant or even just a little chat bot. It's big enough that it's smart and intelligent, and it's small enough that it can actually run on lower end equipment like a cheap server built out of components from eBay or a less cheap MacBook Pro. On the AI server, which of course I named Skynet, we did an average of 37.61 tokens per second. It generated 538 tokens, and it was 0.10 seconds to the first token. The MacBook Pro, 71.51 tokens a second average. 738 tokens were generated to answer the prompt, and the first token took 0.17 seconds. So I'm noticing a trend here. Now, I am not super advanced on the AI research development. I play with it. I enjoy it. I have a couple different projects that use it. And then if you saw my previous video linked up here, I incorporate it heavily into my workflow on this channel. However, I cannot tell you why, for whatever reason, the AI server seems to generate the first token faster. I have no idea why. If somebody knows and can explain that to me, there's P40s in the server, they're Pascal, you know, NVIDIA old server GPUs. I don't understand why. In theory, my MacBook has faster storage, faster, newer RAM, and a significantly faster graphics processor. I don't understand why the time to first token is always, no matter what model is running, always lower on the MacBook. 37.61 tokens a second compared to 71.51. If it isn't already obvious, these MacBooks, they're a beast. And if you want to get into AI, not because you want to build your own Skynet and take down the government, what about 5.4, which is Microsoft's model? It's a 14 billion parameter model. So significantly larger than Hermes, but not quite as large, not quite as gigachungus as the 70 billion. On the Skynet server, 21.83 tokens a second average. It generated 680 tokens and 0.15 seconds to first token. On the MacBook Pro with the M4 Max chip, 37.55 tokens a second. It generated 837 tokens, and it was 0.33 seconds to first token. The second prompt that I gave all three models on both machines was, build me a simple Python app that counts up to 30 seconds and down to zero so I can relax. How did they do? Starting again with the 70 billion parameter model on the Skynet server, 2.14 tokens a second average. It generated 296 tokens, and it was 1.94 seconds to the first token. On the MacBook, 3.43 tokens a second. It generated 428 tokens, and it was 2.46 seconds to first token. Again, that is abysmally slow, but it's impressive. Even in a weight class that this laptop has no business fighting in, it not only ran the model, but I still had a Chrome tab open while I ran the model. I don't expect, again, that you're running a 70 billion parameter model at home, but it's impressive that this machine does it, and it does it well enough. What about the 8 billion parameter model? How'd that do in this Python prompt? On Skynet, 35.49 token a second, 265 tokens were generated, and 0.10 seconds to the first token. On the MacBook, 73.44 tokens a second average. It generated 413 tokens, and it was 0.16 seconds to the first token. Then we get to Microsoft's 5.4 model, which is the 14 billion parameter model. On Skynet, we had an average of 22.04 tokens per second. It generated 268 tokens, and it was 0.18 seconds to the first token. On the MacBook, 41.57 tokens per second average. It generated 262 tokens, and it was 0.26 seconds until the first token. So in LLM-based tasks, the MacBook pretty much decimated the server that we put together a few videos back. The M4 Max chip in my MacBook was turning out a 38.42 average tokens a second, compared to a kind of measly 20.21 from the Skynet server. Now, remember, those are average figures. If you go back a little bit in the video when we were doing the individual models, specifically the 8 billion parameter models, sometimes I'm seeing like 70 tokens a second, which is really good. It's not professional ChatGPT level, but they have thousands of GPUs running one prompt. I have a MacBook. So that kind of performance difference is huge. It means that the M4 Max was performing 47.39% better than the P40s that are in the server over there. The only discrepancy in all the testing for LLMs that I noticed and talked about was that consistently across the board, the Skynet server seems to generate the first token faster. The M4 Max was averaging 1.25 seconds to the first token, whereas the Skynet server was averaging 0.69,
nice,
to the first token. That means that to generate the first token, the AI server was actually 44.59% faster than my MacBook. I still cannot explain that. By all accounts, the MacBook should be beating the server in every metric, but for whatever reason, that time to first token is just lagging behind. But I'm okay with that because my MacBook consistently generated more tokens and did it faster than the server. I can wait an extra half a second for them to start generating. Now, we're going to jump over to a screen recording, and we're going to do some image generation on the two machines and compare those notes. So I have Focus up on the screen. Focus is my preferred web UI platform to use Stable Diffusion. You can load your own models into it, and quite frankly, the interface is really nice and user-friendly, unlike some of the other ones. There are others that you can use. I really like Focus, though. It also works really well on both Windows and Mac. I have not changed anything. I have not even loaded in a custom model. It's still using the stock Juggernaut default. The only thing I have changed in here is to tell it to generate four images because I want it to do a continuous burn. So for each computer, we're going to have the rate at which it took for each image as well as the rate it took for the full image. Also, because the election here in the United States was this week, and whether you agree with it or not, I felt that it was pertinent to show some pride in my country. So the prompt for this image generation for all four is going to be a penguin with a toupee surfing while holding an American flag. Okay, so the image generation finished on the AI server. The first image took 4 minutes and 58 seconds. The second image took 4 minutes and 47 seconds. The third image took 4 minutes and 48 seconds. And the fourth image took 4 minutes and 47 seconds, totaling 19 minutes and 20 seconds. That means that this machine, the Skynet server, has an average of 4 minutes and 50 seconds for its image generation. All right, that's not terrible, but it's not snappy either. So here on the MacBook, we are going to do the same thing. I do have this in dark mode. That's because I actually use it on my MacBook, and dark mode is the only way you should do anything, ever. And I'll see you guys when it's done. All right, so the MacBook did a lot better. The first image took 1 minute and 10 seconds. The second image took 1 minute and 6 seconds. The third image took 1 minute and 23 seconds. And the fourth image took 1 minute and 38 seconds, for a total time of 5 minutes and 17 seconds, with an average of 1 minute, 19 seconds per image. With the Skynet server having an average time of 4 minutes and 50 seconds, and the MacBook having an average time of 1 minute, 19 seconds, that would mean that my MacBook is 72.67% faster than the Skynet server at image generation. To reiterate, in image processing, the MacBook is 72.67% faster than the Skynet server. In LLM performance, the MacBook generates 47.40% more tokens per second than Skynet, and usually it does it while generating more tokens than Skynet. However, if it matters to you for whatever reason that I cannot explain, Skynet is 44.8% faster at time to first token. If anyone knows why, let me know in the comments. So with all of those numbers together, I set up a weighing scale to kind of grade how much better overall my MacBook Pro is compared to the AI server that I built using eBay parts. The scale is as follows. For image generation, it got a weight of 2. For LLM tokens per second, it got a weight of 2. For LLM token count, it got a weight of 1. And for time to first token, because I really don't care about that, as long as it's not like 20 minutes, I rated that at a 0.5. With those weighings and averaging everything together, it puts the MacBook at 48.21% better overall at AI performance than the server that I built. Now, those numbers don't really do this justice. I have a lot of things to say about this MacBook in the review video that is coming soon for it, but just the scope of this, right? So last night when I filmed the MacBook portion of the video, I was using my iPad as a timer. I started looking at memes on my phone and I missed the first two images because they finished so quickly and I wasn't paying enough attention. This thing just feels fast. And it just chews through the models. Even the bigger models, the 70 billion parameter model, it just ate through it. Ultimately, guys, I think if you're in the market to learn and play with AI, don't spend your money on a big server if you already have a high-end computer, like a recent gaming rig with a more modern NVIDIA GPU or a newer Mac. This laptop is sick. All right, guys, that was it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. It was kind of a different styling. I'm trying some different things out. I don't want the channel to get stagnant in its styling. Plus, I really wasn't happy with where the styling was taking me. So I'm trying some new stuff. Let me know what you think down in the comments below. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video. If you are new to the channel and you want to see more of my content, subscribe, hit the bell icon to get notifications. I am Dylan, the Technica's guy, and I will see you guys in the next one. Remember, keep it peaceful.